With innumerable awards and hailed as one of the best contemporary authors alive, Sally Rooney is one author who clearly knows how to win the heart of both the masses and the classes. I discovered Rooney in the summer of 2019 and instantly fell in love with her. Her writing style. She is painfully addictive. And now that her recent novel has just released and I finished it within just 2 days, I thought, well, let's discuss her writings. For the two people who don't know who Sally Rooney is, Sally Rooney is an Irish author who studied philosophy and English at Trinity College Dublin and went on to do an MA in creative writing at Goldsmiths College London before completing her PhD at Trinity College Dublin. She lives in Ireland with her partner, the writer Conal Francis, whom she met when they were both students at Trinity College Dublin. Lately, she has earned the title of being one of the most fearless authors in the business. Over the years, she has won many awards, like in 2017, the Sunday Times Young Writer of the Year, in 2018, Irish Book Award Novel of the Year, in 2018 again, Costa Book Award, and in 2019, Encore Award. But why do I rave so much about her writing? Let me give you a sneak peek so that you also pick up her next book.
Everybody's always going through something, aren't they? That's life, basically. It's just more and more things to go through. I'm not a religious person, but I do sometimes think God made you for me. I think of the 20th century as one long question, and in the end, we got the answer wrong. Aren't we unfortunate babies to be born when the world ended? After that, there was no chance for the planet, and no chance for us.
I love it when women tell women's stories, and Sally Rooney aces them. Her writings pass the Bechdel test even. Created by a feminist cartoonist, Alison Bechdel, in 1985, the test is a simple way to check whether a work of fiction features at least two female characters who talk to each other about something other than a male character. This can be read in Rooney's Normal People and Beautiful World, Where Are You? There are many popular books that don't pass the Bechdel test. Although the Bechdel test is an important observation, it doesn't serve any indication for gender equality, but it does serve as a positive. And that brings me to my next point, where I analyze the positive aspects of Rooney's writing. Character conflicts in her novels feel authentic and believable. You, me, people around us behave the same way her characters behave. Also, I love that her character matures throughout the journey of the books. And it's quite visible, you know. Often, we love to live inside our heads. Her characters too. Her stories are complex, well written, and showcase the struggle of the millennials, and that's why she speaks to this generation and convey the emotions that are hard to communicate. If Sally Rooney decides to publish her to-do list or shopping list, I am going to give my money to buy it. Even the full stops in her writing are romantic. Her stories have very little plot twist and are not written innovatively, but still each one is a page turner. Although she doesn't use quotation mark in her writing, you can clearly know who is speaking to whom. Each character is so distinct. Each one has an original voice. Her conversation in the books are like everyday conversation, two people talking to each other. That's why she is relatable. She has also mastered the art of writing in first-person POV as well as the third-person POV. If you know her personally by any chance, please send her this video. So what are the negatives of Sally Rooney's writing? One thing that really bothers me is when an author lets their philosophy take the front seat instead of storytelling. In Sally Rooney's novels, this is quite visible. At times, some portions feel like unending rant. Apart from her novels, she has written short fictions, my favorite one being Mr. Salary, which is also one of the most popular ones. Like her prose, her poetry also has a distinct nature. This is one that I really like.
It is Monday by Sally Rooney. It is Monday and we are skimming along over rooftops and through Grand Canal Dock. Who knew the sunshine could be so delicious? They should put a warning on it. I am having so much fun with glass I could go blind. And at Lansdowne, the train is more silent than a train ever should be. And at the next stop, we will pass the family home where you are sitting with your unbeknowing parents. And while we soar on past, I look into positively every window in order to give your mother a signal that I exist. Maybe she sees me, who knows, on a June so blue and loving. We pull away into Booterstown, and time is long, cool tide, and two towers, one for each of us, and the single sip of a heron laid flat on the back of June's hand. I will not stop smiling about you. You are the something summer was always meant for, and I wonder how we will love each other so deliciously in autumn. I am making you a quilt of sky and seawater in case we need to remember the places we saw our happiness enlarged.
Before moving ahead, please smash that like button. In the final segment of this video, I want to state that Sally Rooney is a rare voice that should be celebrated and preserved. If you are watching this video, I am pretty sure you have heard this weird news that her book's unpublished advanced copy was sold for hundreds of dollars on eBay. The author is the latest to suffer an attempt at cancelling. Here's why. A critic recently mentioned that in Normal People, Asians are mentioned only as tourists who choke the pathways of museums in Italy, and that's why normal people should be called white people. Being an Asian myself, I want to comment that what the f***? Her craze is so much that the bookshops opened early on the day of publication of her new novel. Sound crazy, right? Well, not crazy enough for a queen. Finally, here is my comparison of her novel on the various mattresses. Link to buy all the books are provided in the description. Also, you can find the links to her other works too. If you loved this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up. The YouTube algorithm will push this video up and more people can see it. Also, you can subscribe to the channel and smash that bell icon. I post videos on books, movies, TV series every single week.